Welcome back, everybody. Honolulu Magazine is the state's best-selling monthly magazine, and the June issue is just out on newsstands and in mailboxes. Editor Robbie Dingman has the latest. Hello. Hey. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me. I mean, donuts, see? Right? If you're already hungry from the donuts, you can move on to being hungry from the restaurant guide.
I'm so excited about this month's issue. A lot of talk about food.
There is. It was a lot of fun. I mean, I have to say this is one of those times when we all go out and we all do different, go to different restaurants, check everything out. Our lead, of course, is our food and dining editor, Catherine Tothbach. Mm-hmm. So she does the bulk of the work. And it is work because you do have to go to different places and pace yourself because you can't just eat constantly, though we try.
Yes, and there's a lot of that on our show as well, so I know exactly what you're talking about.
I know, you do.
So what are some of the things that you found?
So our theme this year was comfort food. So we found that was very fascinating to try to define comfort food because it's nostalgic, it's sentimental, it's something that reminds you of something your family made.
So it's
more food memories.
For everybody.
It completely is. So we sort of skipped around and we suspect that people are going to, you know, complain about some of it. I mean, locomocos in Hawaii, we have 9 of them. I mean, people agree on locomocos. People tend to agree on cheesy things. So there's grilled cheese sandwiches. There's free bread. There's, soups. There's stews. There's mac and cheese. There's ramen. There's fried chicken. But we also threw in some desserts because some people are really heavy on that side of the spectrum that you can't have a comfort food without being something sweet. And yeah, the free bread roundup was a lot of fun. That was Kat's idea, I have to say. So we found quite a bit. We know people are going to argue with us about some of it, but we're okay. We welcome that. What about you? What's your favorite comfort food, you think?
You know, everything, when you said locomoco, I'm like, well, yeah, locomoco. And then when you said dessert, I'm like, yeah, dessert. all of that is comfort food. But it's not just about food, this issue.
No, it's not. I mean, we do have interesting takes on food, and we do have something, but we also have summer books. So it's a book roundup of locally connected books. And there's some fascinating ones, a UH professor talking Lab Girl. She wrote Lab Girl. There's a woman on Kauai who wrote about albatrosses. So there's lots of fascinating books. And, you know, summertime, you always feel like it's time to read.
Yes.
And head to the library. I don't know. They socialize us all wrong. Why do we get summers off when we're kids and then we have to work
right
now? I don't get that.
That's not fair.
So that's one of our other things. Also, we have this fun Neighbor Island getaway to Lanai. Writer Shannon Winnecke, she has a lot of great insider tips, including a few I wish I'd had a chance to take advantage of before this got published.
Because there's been a lot of changes on that island.
A lot of changes over the last 5 years. And, you know, she kind of gives us every entry point you can go to, things to look for, things to take pictures of, and an update on the news. We hope you'll be inspired by all of this to vote in our Haleaina Awards, which are every year, and we have the ballot in this month's magazine and online. So we hope people go in and vote and pick your favorite restaurants because it is a reader poll. You can vote online. You can only vote once from an IP address, so that slows you down if you try to vote from work. You can vote from your phone, but mm-hmm. if one person in your office has voted, you have to vote again.
For people who may not be familiar with the Haleaina Awards, because it's a big deal for Hawaii and it's a big deal for all of the restaurants. Can you explain a little more about that?
It's our dining awards and they've been going on for years. John Heckathorn, the late John Heckathorn, he was shepherded it and it's become quite the event. It started out as a small event to honor the restaurants by having readers vote. And then it got bigger and people want to come to the event mm-hmm. and you've been to the dinner and
yeah.
it's lovely. So it's kind of a little bit of everything, but it's sort of the Grammys or the Oscars of food in Hawaii in many ways. So
what's
we're
great
really
about
on
it too is, like you said, is, you know, we are the ones voting.
Yes.
So whenever you go into a restaurant, they very proudly put up their plaque or whatever, Haleaina Award winner, you know, so it's a big deal.
It is.
We want to go and support them.
It's fun, and we hope people do vote because, you know, it's an important thing. People care about food.
Okay.
And so it's one of the three things I wanted to also remind our everyone about. We also have our first Best of Honolulu event coming up on July 16th. I reminded about that. Oh, and if you
shopping.
Like to shop, thank you,
yes.
shopping. So you have until this Sunday, June 5th, to enter to win a $2,500 shopping spree at Ala Moana Center. And again, www.honolulumagazine.com. It's a Lay Chic shopping spree. So.
Oh. Please. Sign me up.
There, so you just, can.
Okay.
You should.
So nothing you have to do. You can just sign up to win.
That's right. Enter
okay.
to win. So
all right.
I think so. Shopping, reading, eating. Are we set?
We're set. I'm good. Thank you so much, Robbie. I love having you here. You need to pick up your June issue of Honolulu Magazine. All right.